Welcome to another episode of Sunnyside's Dev Streams, where we go over the latest developments about our little game Sunnyside, art, programming, modeling, everything, and even music. I have a few stuff to show you guys. We've done a lot of work on the core stuff. This is still really loud in my head. There we go. We have added a lot of core stuff to the game. As you saw on Discord, we did a lot of stuff on the save system of the game, the day and night advancing, not cycle, like going to the next day. We did a lot of work on Kat. We kind of pretty much finishing all of her art assets. So the first thing to go over before I actually jump into the engine is that we have decided to start using Asana on our team. I don't know if any of you guys know what Asana is. It's essentially just a project manager sort of thing, like a Kanban board, plus a bunch of other features that are really helpful. We used to use Trello for this. If you remember, we had a Trello board to keep track of everything that we do. But we realized that, you know, the project was expanding, and Asana was something that I used in my last job, and it was really good. You could manage other people really well on Asana. It's something that I really missed using Trello. So we have moved to Asana. We already have everybody set up on Asana. That's how actually we've been doing the work in the last week, and it's been really helpful for the team. Everything's been on track. We've been on track with things time-wise. So we moved everything to Asana, and the reason mainly I'm telling you guys about this is because we are going to shut down Trello. There's really no point in having it. Now, one downfall of using Asana is the fact that Asana doesn't come with a public board. So you guys will not be able to see exactly what we're doing like you would be with Trello, but it's a lot more beneficial to the team because of the features Asana comes with. You know, one of the benefits of being in the Discord server is to see things firsthand, but I still have some stuff to show you guys that I've actually have not shown you guys before. Right, so we can jump into the engine. So let's go to our debug map, which is not as pretty as our normal map. So the first thing to go over is the day advancing system thingy. As I mentioned, we worked on a lot of stuff. Let me, by the way, change the season. We're currently in autumn. So there we go. We're spring again. So a lot of core system. And obviously, probably the most core system is the save system and advancing in the day. The way I used to do it before was really stupid, and it was again a remnant of the old mobile game and a prototype version of the game. Basically, every time I wanted to advance the day in game, I would save everything, and then I would advance the day. Actually, I would advance the day, save everything, and then load it again. That is not a very good thing to do. I know it makes sense on paper, but it doesn't make sense in an optimizing way, because especially on a console like Nintendo Switch, that would be really dumb, because everything is already loaded and I'm unloading them. So when a day advances, not many things are changing. Like, I don't need to load an entire house again. I don't need to load an entire building again. So the way the advancing day works in the code is that it just sends a message to everything that is bound to time to, hey, a new day has happened, reset yourself. And it does the same thing to NPCs. And a good way to demonstrate this would be with the soil. So, oh yeah, the character is kind of naked, because another thing that I've been working on is the clothing system, so I apologize for that in advance. Yeah, please don't look at her bum. Or do, I don't know, I won't judge. Anyway, you can see these seeds that have already been planted over here. I mean, I can actually plant some of it myself. We have no animations right now. I have actually removed the animations that we had just to make things quicker and smoother. And I'm just going to plant two of these turnips. Actually, we have another one. There we go. And if I press the button, right, so you can see the days are advancing, because these turnips have grown. And those have turned into withered plants because I did not water them. And if I quickly water these, and we can advance the day. There we go. So now you see nothing changed in the world. The only thing that changed are these turnips, because I have advanced the day, basically. Yeah, I can pick him out of the ground. So that's the way the day advancing works. You might be wondering where the save system is in all of this. So again, you guys have seen a little sneak peek of this before, but I've actually added an app onto your phone. You know, everything is going to be an app on your phone. So Saving system is also an app on your phone, so there we go. It's called Records. If we open it up, we have ourselves over there. You can see, because I'm not wearing any clothes, she's also not wearing any clothes, and that's a cool thing. So basically it captures your avatar last time you save it. And I have two manual saves here that I've done before. Up here it shows your character. The reason we show your character is because you can have multiple careers at the same time. You can have multiple save files of different characters. So up here it shows your character, and it shows that these saves belong to her. Obviously the name, the pronouns, your age, and then obviously shows your farm name as well. And I have not added this yet. I mean, it's in the code, but not visually. But if you click on this, then you will have a list of all the characters that have you have created. And that way you will be able to load a save from another character. You can, of course, edit them. So if I want to, I can go ahead and delete a save. And the cool thing about this is that it will actually delete it from your drive. I can demonstrate this to you guys quickly. There we go. Right. So you can see I have a debug save and another one. And if I delete this, and there you go. That save is just completely gone now. And of course, if you click on it, it will load that save. So at that time that I saved, I was standing right here. I had a campfire down and none of these plants were grown. And yeah, that's how it works. Also, if you want to save, of course, you can open your phone, press new entry. There you go. You have a new save. And if I just open the phone again quickly, that save is now there. And we just saved the game at 14, half past two, basically. And you see, it's just three now. So yeah, that's how the save system works. Also, we do not want you guys to have to open your phone and then open the app and then press new entry. You can, of course, press F5 to quick save. You will have one quick save slot and it will reflect that by up here. You see how it says manual save. We'll say quick save instead. And the game also takes three autosaves every day. The game autosaves in the morning, in the middle of the day, and in the evening. So if you mess anything up and you forgot to save, you can easily go back and load that load. It is quite immersive. So this is called a meta, or a add another word. It's a type of doing UI that makes sense within the world of the game. And I just love doing it like this. Next thing to talk about is the soil that I've already talked about. And the main thing I was going to go over was the fact that I've changed the textures a little bit. They kind of connect to each other. So if I put some more down here. What I mean by connecting to each other is that if I water it, you can see it has like borders and it kind of connects. Yeah, it still doesn't look that great in my opinion, so we could definitely even improve the textures even more, but that is it for now. And the code was completely broken after I tried to overhaul the system, but now it's all working. So if I plant those things, you've already seen this, you know, we go ahead in the day. They're all withered now because I did not water them for 3 days straight, which is, by the way, how long the plants will wither if you do not water them. I will show you cat. Have actually on my list it says cat portraits next, so I guess I have to do that. So you guys already saw a dialogue system that I posted today. I can actually show you guys how that looks in game. And if you go in here and I press A, this is obviously just a demonstration. So there she is. She blinks, of course. All of the portraits will blink, even like having different emotions and all of that, they all will all blink. And yeah, this is a good overhaul to our old dialogue system. We used to have a 3D model down here, but I'm really glad we went with the 2D, because there is a lot more emotions that I can show on a 2D anime face. I just could not do that on a 3D one. So there we go. It shows the name up there, shows the text, obviously. It'll even show a little arrow as it does on every JRPG, basically. And this is like your relationship indicator. So this will be more grown the higher the relationship level is. But currently, it's at, I think, 3. That means 3. This is something, again, that I want to change. This is just a placeholder right now because it does not look great. But yeah, this is, yeah. And one more thing that you guys haven't seen are the rest of the portraits. I have that ready for you guys Here they are. So this is her neutral face. And also these are the kind of emotions that you can expect for every character. And every one of these have two versions. So one is closed eyes, one is open eyes. And I can, you know, toggle between them to basically show them blinking. And this is a happy that we have, but we also made a second happy version for her. We had this originally, but we thought it doesn't really work. We thought this kind of smile would work a lot better with her personality. So that's why I asked Kayori to do this, and we kept this version as well. We might use it somewhere. We have it, so why not? One thing that I was worried about originally was the quality of these. I wanted these to be high quality persona-like portraits and not just, you know, not greatly shaded flat portraits, but I think she has delivered, and I'm really thrilled with these. I love them, absolutely love them. This is her sad one. Yeah, we have, yep, sad blink. This one is the shocked sort of one. This one is blushed, as you can see she's blushing, and this one is angry, and this one is thinking. Yeah, so these are the kind of emotions that you can expect every character to have. We have neutral, happy, sad, shocked, blushed, angry, and thinking. And it should pretty much cover everything. This is, this should cover everything. And this is, by the way, how we do the animations. This is called, you guys probably already know what this is. It's just a spreadsheet. And Unreal Engine, yeah, just like many other engines, it still uses sprite sheets. They call them flipbooks in Unreal. Yeah, it goes, each one of these is basically a frame, and the game will go through it. And in the engine itself, it will look something like this. Yeah, and that's how she blinks. One more thing about Cat and other characters in the game are the improvements we've done to the textures of them. So you guys probably already seen this, but I've decided to modify the textures a little bit to make them look a little bit prettier. Basically add a little bit of blush, add a little bit of, not really makeup, but just more dimension to the faces by adding a bit more color to it. And this is Catherine again, and I think her model looks a lot better. We've also experimenting with something like hair physics. So her hair in this model actually does have physics. And, you know, if I play an animation, come on, just move your head, please. You can kind of see it a little bit. Yeah, it looks more like cloth. So that's why we want to make it a little bit more thick so that the hair physics are a little bit better. We've also finally added some facial animations to the 3D models. She can basically blink in her 3D model. So yeah, that's that. Put it back to zero. There's a happy sort of thing, that one. There's like an angry one. There's a sad one. And yeah, we'll basically do this on the 3D models so that it's not just a portrait you're seeing, but the 3D model is also reflecting that. And I think that would be very necessary. You guys already know that music is a huge part of Sunnyside, and we're going with that whole jazzy persona sort of vibe. And talking with Matthew, our composer, we've decided to hire some real saxophone players. We decided to hire a real sax player, a real string player, and like have more orchestral performances. And thanks to your backings on Kickstarter, we can actually afford it somewhat. So do still support us, please. We decided to bring in some saxophone players, and Matthew showed me, basically gave me a taste of how a real sax player would sound in our tracks. So I'll have a little bit of like a preview sort of thing. This is not exactly Sunnyside soundtrack, but the direction of the soundtrack I want to take. This is still Matthew's work, but this is what he wants to do with this track. So I'm going to quickly play it for you guys a little bit, so you guys can hear what that might sound like. Thank you. This is called Bossa Nova, this kind of music. And we want to have a lot of these tracks for shops, menus, and some events, or maybe if you go into the cafe. And I am a huge fan of Bossa Nova. Some people call this kind of music elevator music, but I love it. It's just so relaxing. There's another one, which is actually a new track coming to Sunnyside. And this is still work in progress, but I'm going to play a little bit of it so you guys can have a listen. And this is the track we want to use for menus and stuff. Character creating. Yeah. Continuing on the topic of music, we are actually going over some of the older tracks like the spring theme and the winter theme and all of that, and we're actually going to redo them or overhaul them because those tracks were so old. And you know, ever since we released Breezy and the Neon Nights soundtrack that you guys heard, they have a very staple sort of sound. You know, when you hear them you can tell that okay, this is from Sunnyside. But the spring theme and the winter theme and the stuff before that, and even, yeah, so they didn't have this kind of staple theme to them. So we're gonna go back to them and overhaul them and change them and make them more jazzy, I guess, make them more Sunnyside. And I'm really excited to do that. So we're gonna start with Spring, and we're gonna make our way through the rest of the tracks. So the next thing I want to talk about is actually a big part of the inventory stuff that I've worked on, but it's also why our character is naked currently. So if I open our inventory, you can see it's we have the character portrait, sort of, not portrait, but just a preview of the character on the left, and she's not wearing anything because all of these slots are empty. And what I've been working on in the past basically 3-4 days is to actually make you be able to put these clothes on. And why it was so difficult to do is because some of the clothes will block other slots under here. So basically, if you wear a dress, you can't wear trousers on top of that. Or if you're wearing dungarees, again, you can't wear trousers with that. Or maybe you're wearing something that you cannot wear something underneath. And that's what I've been working on, and it's working finally now. And basically, if you have any dress or outfits, it will go in here in this slot, which is top over. But I'm just gonna wear a white shirt, or that's not a white shirt, it's a blue shirt. Don't mind the thumbnails, I just didn't have time to make the thumbnails, so they're just trees. But yeah, that's how you put it on. You can take it off. And for example, if I go ahead and put these blue dungarees over on that slot, you can see that this slot for trousers has this block icon over it, and I cannot put anything inside it anymore because it's been blocked by this. I can still put something in here, but nothing in the bottom. Last thing to talk about on today's stream is the minimap. So we have changed the minimap system completely. I had programmed a minimap system earlier in the code. It was not really optimized, it was not really great, but I decided to completely delete everything that I've done on that side, and we have got ourselves a basically a minimap system. It was kind of expensive, but it was very, very well worth the money. First of all, you might have noticed that I already have a map up here. This is obviously not a final map. This is just a render of the map I'm on. The reason this is good is because we can do debug stuff on it. So basically, in the final game, this map is not going to be just an image of the world. It's going to be handcrafted map. But for now, this works really well. As you can see, the system really works well because there's a deposit box over here, and you can see it shows it on the map. If I even hover over it, it will tell me what that is. And they're also sticky if you want them to be, so they will kind of stick to the side of the map if you go way too far from it. And another really good thing that comes with this map is the fact that it has Fog of War. If you don't know what Fog of War is, it's kind of like those RTS games, like Age of Empires, when you as you walk through the map you kind of discover it. We're going to use that system for our caves and some of the lower levels of the cave, which you will not have a map for right away, but it will kind of opens itself and you discover it as you go through it. This system also comes with leveling, like different levels of elevation. So if you're in a building basically, and you have a top floor and a bottom floor, depending on whatever floor you are, you will get the map of that floor. And if there's an objective under you, it will turn into like a triangle to show you if it's above you or if it's below you. This minimap system also comes with a full big map you can toggle to. So if you open the map app on your phone, you can open it up and you can tag things on it, kind of like Zelda. Lemon, question. How is your artist so good? I don't know. I'm just really lucky to have a really good artist. It actually has elevated the project a lot ever since we had him. If you remember before that, we had characters that, you know, the 3D models looked good, but, you know, we didn't have 2D models. But more importantly, these portraits and these arts will really help the PR because I have something to post on our socials that I know people who are fans of this genre will really love. In these games, you know, JRPGs, of course, you know, a 3D model of a character is really important, but the thing you mainly fall in love with, the thing that you really remember a character by, are their 2D portraits, you know? Huge fan of Persona, obviously. So whenever I think of Ryuji or An, characters from Persona, or Yusuke, my favorite, I think of their portraits. The portraits is what comes to my mind. And that is probably, I should probably have this on my face. That is probably the most important thing about a character's visuals when it comes to a JRPG. So I'm really glad to have that. Is that a gray city in the background? Yeah, that is, I can show you guys a better look of that. Open this. This is something I've shown before. It's just a outline of how I want the city to kind of look like. So layout. So this is the town layout, sorry. And yeah, so we're gonna have some buildings down there. There's gonna be a road here. And again, we have a little bit of it already in the game, which I've shown before, of Streets of Sunnyside. Yeah, that's everything. I think that's it for this dev stream. It was really quick and straight to the point, this one, right? It's because I actually wrote things down over here. One more thing actually I forgot to talk about is that from a developer side, right? We, in terms of optimizing things, we're using something called level streaming in Sunnyside. And level streaming is basically when you have little smaller levels that are part of a grander level and they can load and unload at will. So basically, if I'm on this level and if I want to go to the main map, I can do that because they are part of the same world. And I will explain this further in the future, but basically what this means is that every building and every house is going to be different levels, but part of the same huge level. And it's basically going to be a lot more optimized, a lot more quicker to for things to work. And we also have a little tiny loading screen that looks pretty cute for now. Yeah, it is loading. So many good things in such a short time. Thank you guys. I always worry that there's not enough done, so it's really good to hear that you guys think that, because we definitely want to have a good game to show to these publishers so that they know Sunnyside is worthy of their time and money. Things to look forward to are going to be Gabriel's portraits, a few more clothes for the female or feminine body main character, and some new soundtracks for the game. I will see you all in the next dev stream. Take care and see you all later.